is a release on the TV from the book of Deuteronomy chapter 10, from verse 22 to 27. Some of us did not read the reading at mass.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Deuteronomy chapter 10, verse 22. When your ancestors went to Egypt, there were only 70 of them.
From verse 12.
Verse 12. Now, people of Israel, listen to what the Lord your God demands of you. Worship the Lord and do all that the Lord commands. Love Him, serve Him with all your hearts, and obey all the laws. I am giving them to you today for your benefit. To the Lord belong even the highest heavens. The earth is His also, and everything on it. But the Lord's love for your ancestors was so strong that He chose you instead of any other people. And you are still His chosen people. So then, from now on, be obedient to the Lord and stop His love. The Lord your God is supreme over all gods and over all powers. He is great and mighty, and He is to be feared. He does not show partiality, and He does not accept bribes. He makes sure that orphans and widows are treated fairly. He loves the foreigners who live with our people and gives them food and clothes. So then, show love for those foreigners, because you are once foreigners in Egypt. Obey the Lord your God and worship only Him. Be faithful to Him and make your promise. Your promises in His name alone. Praise Him, He is your God, and you have seen with your own eyes the great and astounding things that He has done for you. When your ancestors went to Egypt, there were only 70 of them. But now, the Lord your God has made you as numerous as the stars in the sky. Amen.
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 May the Lord multiply us and bring increase in our lives through our obedience to Christ our Lord. From that reading, I want us to reflect on the heart of true religion, the requirement for blessing. The heart of true religion, requirement for blessing. We go, O God, in pity as a people that He has created in His divine alignments. And that duty is also not resisted up into God, but also extends to our neighbor and then to ourselves. So we have a tripartite duty in life as children of God, and true religion is found in this tripartite sense: to God, to your neighbor, and towards yourself. And for us to be able to do that, which is the ingredient that makes religion our worship of God through, we have these basic things to do. One, we must fear the Lord our God. That is the number one, and that is the demand of God of the Israelites. Just like the word of God we say in the book of Revelation, chapter 14, verse 6 to 7, it says, then I saw another angel flying high in the sky, sent to proclaim the everlasting good news to the inhabitants of the earth, to every nation, race, language, and people. He cried out with a loud voice, fear God and give Him glory, for the hour of His judgment has come. Worship Him who made the heaven and the earth, the sea and the springs of water. That's the first demand, and that is attributed to God, to fear God. And this fear of God is not just a fear that is born out of that He would destroy you. No. It is reverential fear, honor, and respect. That when you honor Him, and when you worship Him in truth and spirit, then He will bless you. And so obedience to that submission to Him. The second thing we also need to do is we must love Him above all else. Desire Him all times and every moment. Because He is ours. God is ours. He created us for Himself and also for us, for Him. We are made for Him, and He is also made for us. That's why He seeks communion with us. If you remember in the book of Genesis, He made man in His image and likeness of the day. He came back to the garden seeking for Adam and what? Eve. And what was it He was looking for? Companionship. Not necessarily that God was lonely. No. Himself, His divinity is enough for Him. But He does not just want to enjoy that joy, that beauty of Himself alone. He extends love to us by creating us in His image and likeness. And that's why He came back looking for man. When He said to Adam, 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 where are you? And then He hid Himself because of sin. And then the Lord continued to search for Him. And that is how God searches for us. Tell the Lord, I don't know where you are hiding, but I pray that the Lord will search you out. For your own blessing, not for destruction, but for your own world's blessing. So that you can commune with Him. When you commune with Him, you will have a reason to say, I bless you for communing with me. Then the third thing is, we must walk in His ways. Those are the demands of that text. That is the ways which He has appointed us to walk in. And that again has to do with God's divine and revealed will. What is the will of God for me? Particularly in our different experiences, are they in consonance with the divine will of God? And do I also align myself with this divine will of God? The problem many of us have as children of God and in our worship of God is that sometimes we look towards ourselves and our own will. We set the goal for God, not following the goals that God has set for us. Remember, when He says, I know my plans for you. That is God's will. We set a plan for God and we want Him to align with our own plan. No, our plan must align with the plan of God for our own salvation. And then the fourth thing that we must also do is that we must serve Him whole and entire. Our service of God must be total, holistic, no reservation. And then the fifth thing for our religion to be true and honest, and then open a channel of blessing for us, is that we must keep His commandments and His statutes. God has given His commandments and His statutes to us, and then He expects us to abide by them. For when we do, then channel of blessing will be opened for us. Can I hear you say amen? I don't know who wants to be blessed by God. Who? Are you sure you want to be blessed by God? Huh? You want? Then if you want God to bless you, are you ready to do His requirements? Are you sure? That today you will not lie to anybody. And any word that will come out from your mouth today will be honest words. Can you? Are you sure? Can we be God? Can we really pay God? And so I those in the choir, can you look for him 4-2-1 for me? Like that big hymn, him 4-2-1. Now, when the Lord has said these things, he makes a demand. Look up for me, Psalm 116:12. What God requires of us, the demand of this that is put forth to us through Moses, demanding a question, and the question is, how can I repay the Lord for all his goodness?
What can I offer the Lord for all his goodness to me? I will bring a wine offering to the Lord.
The cup of salvation I will want, I will raise.
To thank him for saving me, in the assembly of all his people, I will give you what I have promised. How painful it is to the Lord when one of his people dies.
Just put it there, praise the Lord. Mm-hmm. How can I repay the Lord for his word, goodness to me? How can we repay the Lord? In fact, can we really repay the Lord? Can we?
No.
We cannot. Your life is a gift to you. Of course, how you came into the world, you can't even explain. But on top of that, he has made a promise to us. He will keep blessing us, but he requires only one thing from you. And that's why that song is Psalm 4:2-1 of that hymn says, what can I offer to them, Lord, to make him happy? What can I offer to the Lord to please him?
Give him the best of my heart.
Have you seen it there? What can I offer to the Lord to make him happy? The onions and the heights of the earth. they are made by me. The earth is my footstool, and I look down upon the surface of the earth, because I am God. What is it that you can give me? The sacrifices of fools and goats I do not desire, but all I need from you is your praise and worship. That is the demand of a true religion. And when we abide in this, God blesses us. He is moved by these dispositions. These dispositions that God requires of us are not external, but rather they are inward. They come from the inside of us, and it is pervasive. This demand of God is pervasive. When it comes upon you, you cannot resist it. There are some of us who walk in the dark and dark and dark, and normally the Lord comes with his heavy power, with his strong righteous hand. He says, today is you, I'm finishing with you, and he crafts you. And you see yourself rolling here on the ground and weeping and crying, and that day you submit yourself. You will just exclaim like a fall. All that have happened before, I consider them as what?
Nothing.
Garbage. And then you begin to seek him and the power of his resurrection. That is what he wants of us. That is the demand. The prophet Micah in chapter 6, verse 8, puts it beautifully. Look up for that chapter for me. He says, what does God demand of us? What is the requirement for your blessing? He says, to do justice, to love mercy, and to walk humbly before him. Check it out. Not too much. Simple. Simple but heavy, and heavy loaded. To do justice. How many of us are proponents of justice? How many of us? Today, Monday, through Saturday, Friday, Sunday. Sorry, Sunday, Friday, Saturday, what? Sunday. How many of us will uphold justice from today till that day? How many of us? How many of us can uphold justice? You are not answering me. Is that my power? How many of us this week will say, this week I will walk in justice, no matter what. Before 10 o'clock this morning, many of us have performed a lot of injustice. This is in Proverbs 11. We come from Proverbs 11 from verse 1. Injustice.
Proverbs 11 verse 1. The Lord hates people who use dishonest gifts.
The Lord hates people who use what? Dishonest what? Skills.
He is happy with honest ways.
He is happy with what? Honest what? Ways. So today, how many of us will uphold? I'm not talking about tomorrow. I'm only talking about just what? Today. How many of us will uphold justice? Honest ways. But the desire of all of us is that God should bless what? They are not answering me. Because we are guilty and we will be guilty. I said before 10 o'clock today, some of us have fallen what? Victims of injustice. And these all are blessings. He has already packaged blessing for us, but with our own hands, we stop the blessing, it gets stuck. And then he says, love mercy. When you love mercy, God is what? Merciful. And he says, in the Beatitudes, he will show mercy to the one merciful. Some of us are angry with some persons. Somebody offended you yesterday or even last week. Have you forgiven the person? And God be magnified. you raise your hand, what does it see? Lack of mercy in your hand. And the thing is crying. When you open, when the Israelites open their hand this week, they are opening to give and receive blessing. But when you open, and what it sees, we bring blessing to deposit on their hand. But there's a blockage. It's dirty. We want hard heart. I'm talking of lack of mercy to the person who has offended you, that he demands you to forgive. So the thing is saying, I'm crying that he should forgive me. He has said, over his dead body, will he do what? Forgive me. And so he withdraws the blessing. Because you're not giving up what you are holding, but you want him to deposit his blessing for you. I pray that the Lord will give you the grace to forgive. Some of us are not walking in humble ways before him. Lord mercy. Walk humbly. Are you humble? Because of what small gifts God has given you.
Who are you? Do you know me actually?
I know who I'm talking to. You are Mr. This plus Mr. What? Stand. That's what you are. That's who you are. If you like, have all the money in the world. It's not your product, it's a gift from God. And that's why he says, walk humbly. Don't become arrogant with the blessings that God has given to you. Nobody talks to you and you listen. It must always end in your own words. Why must I listen to you? Who are you? What knowledge do you have? What importance do you have in society? Me, I belong to this world. I am the CEO of this. I am that. I am. Yes, we agree. Gracious, yes, God. But that should make you humble. Amen. Amen. One of the greatest presidents of the world is the president of the United States of America. We talk about countries that their presidents wear power, dignity, money, anything you can think of, we talk of America. A few days ago, I was watching something on Facebook and I saw the president of America, Joe Biden, came into a place for a ceremony. I think it was an interactive session with the media, and one black shirt woman rushed the president. Oh my God, this man, he grabs the man. I said, the day is her best day, the best day of her life. Having to grab the president stood, embraced her. And at the end, she struggled to bring out her phone to take a snapshot with the president. And because of the joy of that encounter with the president, she didn't know how to operate her phone again. Joy that the president is amnesty. You know what the president said? The president said, take your time. Take your time. He waited for her to be able to know how to operate her phone again. He said she was able to on her phone. Then the man took snapshots with her. Everybody was clapping. That is humility. In Nigeria, can you hear Buhari? Hear me, you are away in the conference. Your parishioners are like,
you are there,
they are there.
Nothing intangible, they don't touch you. When they touch you, they defy you. Say so. Relate with them. I had some visitors yesterday, three of them from where I worked before, one village, presently the Roberts village.
There was something they said, Father, that someone was asking of you, that father that used to, when you used to be there, that used to be there, every compound. Now where is he?
I started laughing.
I said, yes, at that point, where I was, I needed to come down to their level and relate with them. Every child in the community knew my name.
What old mama? I don't forget that. Mama has nothing. Mama will come for morning mass with palm oil she has scrapped and put inside her breasts. After morning mass, she will walk over to me. Now me. She will open her breast and bring the palm oil and give me. I will collect it and I will chew it. This one that I will say in this prayer, I will go to class and I will share the palm oil with them and will chew. Because it was a gift coming from the heart. That's humility. Mama will come for money and she has nothing. She will go to her flower and collect two eggs. Put it inside the alarm and she will come. Now, take it. And I will collect the egg and will not reject it. She will go to her farm and bring the egg and come and give me. I will collect it and I eat it. Some evenings I will stroll to her house and sit with her by the fireside. When she is preparing food with vegetable and small fish, I will sit with her. She will be speaking the language that will be once I understand that they will be interacting with English. And then thereafter she will call the son in Portugal and then her father came to visit me in my house. It gave Mama joy.
That's what he says in the Psalm 146. verse 8 and 9, says the Lord protects the stranger. He cares for them. And he cares and protects the widow and the orphan often because they are strangers. Have you married strangers? Have you married widows? Have you married orphans? What is your disposition towards them? In your family, someone has lost a husband. What is your attitude to her? You want to chastise and deal with her because she was not having a husband. And you want to say, you want him to bless you, bless others. These things cannot be possible in us when we do not do the requirements of the Lord. And what does it say? It says before now, God gave an instruction to Moses, to Abraham, sorry. It says, every child in your house must be what? Circumcised. Everybody say.
Circumcised.
Must be what? When the Lord gave that instruction, and Moses did not, Abraham did not keep it. He was journeying. At the point, God wanted to strike him because he did not obey the injunction of circumcision. The wife had to do what? Use something and cut him. And then also, he circumcised his son. Then God's anger stayed. The cutting of the flesh, the foreskin of the flesh. But in our text this morning, that has changed. Praise the Lord. So let me go for that next verse 16 of 8. Let me see what it says there in that thing, the exact. This is the one that says circumcision of the foreskin of the one. Can I hear you?
Amen.
Not of the flesh, but of the hearts. Did you see? Is this 16 from the exams? 20. Is it that chapter of Deuteronomy 10, verse 16 of 8? I think it talks about circumcision of the heart, the foreskin of the heart, not of the flesh. And what does that imply? That your circumcision is not just of the flesh, but it must penetrate to the heart. Because the Lord says, sin comes from the world, the heart, not from the exterior. And that's why when they ask Jesus, what defiles the man? He says, it comes from the world, heart. The condition of evil comes from the inside of us and manifests itself. And that's why the Lord says, from the abundance of the heart, the man does what? Speaks.
Amen.
Amen. And so this thought of your blessing that will come to you from the Lord must be a product of the circumcision of the heart. When your heart is circumcised, then God will see your interior.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
I know some people are already planning how they will cheat some people today when they go to market.
That God, the Holy Ghost,
let it bounce from you.
Make honest profits in your business, not the mind to cheat. Somebody comes and is looking for Bosch. Is it Bosch? Those who sell car products. Is it Bosch?
Yes. Yes.
Bosch product, Abby. Is there anything like that?
Yes.
Bosch, Give him that one. Don't bring him and say, okay, I just have that hand and you rush him. Come here. Mizia, copy, yes, sir. Because he doesn't know, give him the one he wants. Even if he does not mention the name, bring it to show them in the price. This is educate the man because they're like, if I come to buy, so I not so. When I meet you in trust, confidence, I say, well, after I come, we're still 3 years ago. I can't remember that. I said, I know. The next thing, it worked within one time. Tell me the correct one. If I have the money, I will do what? I will don't have, I will say, no, I don't want someone. Give me what I can do, what? I thought that when your heart is pure, you have a heart of love, and when you do that, God will bless you. Don't cheat.
Many of us are those holding back our blessings,
and I pray that the Lord will forgive us our sins in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Now, when you do all this, God says, I will bless you. We've come this month to come and draw power and strength to begin a new day and a new week with the Lord. I pray that this strength will follow you.
Yeah.
I pray it will follow you.
Yeah.
On Monday, it will follow you.
Yeah.
On Tuesday, it will follow you.
Yeah.
On Wednesday, it will follow you. Positions you for God's blessing is walking in His ways. And then when the Lord had given them that injunction, look at what is added. Before then, when Moses had to also speak to them in Deuteronomy chapter 6, he says, from verse 5, or some we say from verse 6, yeah, O Israel, the Lord our God is one God, that you must love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and all your energy. And this word that I command you this day must be in your words, hearts. Everybody say hearts. You teach your children. Your sons and daughters, I said, when you wake up in the morning, you think of those words of the Lord. When you sit in your house, you meditate on it. When you walk by the way, you illuminate them. And they guide, they become your conscious identification every moment by those words. In your dealings with me and the next person, that's why the three responsibilities to God, to neighbor, and love yourself is important. He said, when you walk by the way, when you lie down, when you sleep, and when you do all, wake up, even in your subconsciousness, it should be recycling. And I wonder why God will not bless you with those. Amen.
Amen.
And then the Lord then added, look for the Deuteronomy 11 for me, verse 22. Or from verse 20 to 22 or thereabouts, or beyond that, and see what he says. And I pray that that will be your experience this day.
Amen.
In the Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Deuteronomy 11, verse 20.
Yes.
Write them on the doorpost of your house.
Write these laws on the doorpost of your household.
And on your gates.
And on your gates. Children will live long time on the land I give you. What is the land that God has given in your house, in your business, in your place of work? You will be established in it. Can you say amen? Because you will receive the word of God, you will think about it, and it will guide your actions. Go on.
You will live there as long as there is a sky above the earth.
As long as there is a sky above, see the limits. See the framework that God gives us is a limitless bound. For some of us who have traveled before, you end up living. If you go outside and look up, you think that the thing ends here, have you? When you just look here, you see the ends here, you say that anyway. Anyway, bow. When you enter the plane, when it takes off, it passes this one you are seeing. When it passes this one, it's just like a slab moving or moving. The plane will pierce it and then get to a space that is as free as here. There's nothing. And then after the dances here, there's a level that is just free. And the place just keeps going there. And then from that level, it goes up, up, up. Yet you will see another one up. But you can touch it on the day Ruaka. On the door of the city Ruaka. That is how, and so God says, your blessing will be measured from the earth to the ends of the world. Sky. So it's limitless. This is what it offers us. So that when we walk and stand in His consciousness, we know no bounds. You are a limitless child of God. That is what you are. That's why when the Lord is with you, nobody can do what? Stop you. But many of us have stops. Because we forget it. Let me use the word 3 hours. The responsibility to serve to God.
Do everything He commands and be faithful to Him.
Amen. You see, God is not selfish. But He will always talk about Himself what? First. Because He's the omniscient. He is the battleground. He is the source. And from Him everything flows. So that's why it says loveliness.
Then He will drive out all those nations as you are advanced.
Then He will drive out those nations as you are advanced. And what are those nations? Sickness. Untimeliness. Failure, disease, evil men and war, women, witches and war, witchcraft. These are the nations before us. Hindrances on your way, projected failures onto you and your family. He says, He will do what? Try them away. Because on your own, you do not have the power to do this. He is the one who has the power to do what? Do it if you obey Him.
And you will occupy the land belonging to the nation greater and more powerful than you.
Can I say this, son? Just say, I occupy my land now. I take my position now. It's a position of my blessing. Because of His grace of favor upon me. I shall overcome. In the name of Jesus. Just sit in here, son. Sit down. You will occupy it, nobody will push you out. And anybody planning to push you out will fall. Because He has said, I will bless you.
All the grounds that you march over will be yours.
Can you imagine that? All the grounds that you march over will be yours. God is faithful. When Moses died, Joshua was chosen by him in Joshua chapter 1. He said to him, my servant Moses is there. Now I give you the mantle of leadership. And he said, be courageous and serve me like Moses did. And this will happen to him. He said, anywhere the sole of your feet will land, I will give you as a possession. And I declare that for you this morning. Because of His favor and blessing. Because Elohim is here, and you are sitting on this ground consecrated to Elohim, Elohim will bring you and walk you to your place of favor.
Let the Lord who made this promise to you do this. in your life, and he will give you a testimony to what he has said about you. In the name of Jesus. If a man has made a negative pronouncement against you, by the promise of the Lord this morning, may that pronouncement be reversed in the name of Jesus. God somewhere because of you. Say that this week we shall deal with it. They will see you walking in dominion. They will wonder how you came out this week. And they will be wondering, is it that the thing did not work? Because it will not work because you are carrying a greater dish.
Because the king has said, I will be with you. And your territory will not know limits. That is your face. And he grants your face. And he bless your face. And he increase your face. In the name of Jesus.
Wherever you go in that land, the Lord your God will make the people fear you. As he has promised, and you won't be able to stop you.
Amen.
Gentlemen, I don't know if I ask you this morning. I know there are some of you as you are arriving in the shop this morning. Oh, they get it.
He has come again. He has come again. And he will do what?
They will cease. So shall we intimidate him.
You will be an intimidation to that man that says, I will deal with you. Because there is a mark of glory on your forehead. At your back,
the last day. Anybody who knows is about you? Nah, come on. Let's go and talk on your back now. Nah.
Of your standing on this ground. everything to you in the name of Jesus.
But they are stubborn and kept going their own way. I have seen how they acted, but I believe them.
May He heal you. May the Lord heal our lives. May He heal our church. May He heal our families. May the Lord heal the life of your business. May the life, Lord, heal the life of your workplace. That thing that seems to be calling and calling, may life come back to it. Let men glorify God in what He has done in your life. In the name of Jesus.
I will lead them and help them.
Chat.
And I will comfort those who mourn.
Chat. Your morning shall become the time of celebration. You have mourned enough. And God says, I've remembered you. Let Him remember you. You are always celebrating other people's own blessing. No one has ever come to bless you, to tell you to bless and thank God. But this season, I pray for you that God will make you to be uplifted and be remembered by people in the name of Jesus. You will not only be going for celebrations for people alone, but you shall join, they shall join you to go for celebration this season in the name of Jesus.
Those
of you outside, come inside the church,
please. Both me and fire. I will heal my people. For evil people are in the restless area, restless sea, whose ways never come running in. Bringing peace and more. There is no safety for sinners, says the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
The Lord says His blessing is not just limited to you. Our God is a God who walketh in action with us. I know there is a brother of yours who want God to bless this one. I know there is a sister of yours who want God to bless this one. I know there is a friend of yours who want God to bless this one. Because you are sitting on this house, consecrated to be through Him. Let that blessing transmit from you to the person wherever he or she is now in the name of Jesus.
God with what? Us. Not just with you, but with
to God, to neighbor, and to what? Self.
Yeah.
And the yoke of injustice.
Yoke of injustice.
And let the oppressed go free.
Let the oppressed go free. That was the mission of Jesus. When he quoted Isaiah chapter 62, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me to bring good news to the poor, to proclaim liberty to captives, to let the oppressed be free, to open the eyes of the blind, and to make them hear, and to declare the year of God's favor and resurrection for the dead. Are you contributing to that, or you are bringing back those chains the Lord has removed from people onto them? If you are, the Lord is speaking to you this morning. For you to open hands and receive blessings from me, then you must do the need. And that is how I'm walking in His lights.
Share your food with the hungry.
Share your food with the hungry.
And open your doors to the homeless.
And open your doors to the homeless. There is gender.
Give you food to those who are not.
Do something out there, my sister. Have you ever given food to somebody? Some of us have been blessed. Have you ever given someone some blessings you cannot use? Put some good people and give that to them. Or you put it in the box in what is there. Someone is walking naked. You see the person every day, even your younger sister and younger brother. And you do like a 29 hour. The Lord is speaking to you, child of God, this morning. That is where your blessing lies. When you do it to them, you are giving it to them. He said, I was naked. And you never heard that again. I pray that the Lord will not speak those words, those harsh words to you on the last day in the name of Jesus.
And you must refuse to help your own relatives. Then my favor will shine on you like the morning sun.
My favor will shine on you like a morning one. Son, let the Son of God's favor be raised upon us this morning in the name of Jesus. Including me, yeah, it is. Not only you. Let Elohim remember you. Let the morning sun carry favor to you. I don't know where you are, wherever it is you are, and you're going this week. Let that raise of favor locate you. In the name of Jesus.
And your wounds will be quickly healed.
And your wounds will be healed. That you have sustained physical and spiritual wounds. Some of us are carrying emotional wounds. I pray for that emotional wound to be healed now. Somebody has hurt you. You say, I will not forgive him. I will not forgive him. Child of God, oh precious Holy Spirit of God, I pray that you melt that stone in that heart this moment in the name of Jesus. That psychological wound that is battering you and battering you. May the Lord's Spirit heal it this hour in the name of Jesus. That emotional hurt you're going through, that pain you're going through, the pain of a lost one, the pain of a lost dear person, the pain of something you love that is so precious to you, that is making you not to change well, may God Himself heal you of that pain in the name of Jesus.
And I will always be with you to save you.
And I will always be with you to save you.
My presence.
Any projection granted for you this week, let it come to mountain. I know many of you will travel this week. Many of you will go to places this week. May God's protection join you with you. May the hand of God that is the product of this fellowship within this morning, journey with you and guiding and leading and making you guide you safety, safe journey in the name of Jesus.
And my friend,
and His presence will protect you on every side. In the morning, in the afternoon, in the evening, and in the night. Let the Lord be there with His troop and His staff to defend you. In the face of the angel of death, may the Lord fight back for you. And may no projected accident locate you. When you pass, they will say it happened before you. When you are behind, it will happen in front before you arrive. And you will pass. You will pass.
victorious and joyful in the name of Jesus. I don't care who has said that it is you they are looking for this week. They will not see you. Because Elohim is your father. Adonai is your father. You are Yahweh Mekadishkem is your father. Ruah Elyon will be with you. He will guide you in the morning, in the afternoon, and in the evening in the name of Jesus.
For you, that the way you march and step on it, your leg will swell. That will not happen in the name of Jesus. I confirm on you, on